Hey guys, this is the first episode of a new series in the channel called App Detour, where I review an application that is either too hyped up or too underrated. And the app that I chose to review today is a launcher called LAWNCHAIR. So I found this launcher in a review posted in XDA Developer's YouTube page. And guess what? This app is developed by an XDA member. So it makes sense when they hyped it up way too much in the video. And I thought that it would be a great idea reviewing it, and here it is, the unbiased review of the LAWNCHAIR launcher. Okay, so to begin with, the app is not available in the Play Store, so you'll have to download it from the XDA page, and that would be a deal breaker for some. Anyway, I'll leave a link down below for those who feel like checking it out. And when I looked at this thing for the first time, it didn't blow my mind or anything. In fact, it looked really boring after using Mi Launcher for a few days. And after spending some time with the settings and doing some tweaks here and there, it looked way better. I have left the whole list of things that you can tweak in the setting down below in the YouTube show notes, so make sure that you check that out. And yeah, talking about the settings, this dude has a bunch of handy features in it, which is nothing even when compared to the free version of Nova Launcher. And there are some minor issues with this thing which I found really frustrating. I'll come to that in a bit. But considering the fact that the app is in its early stages, all of these can easily be forgiven. Now let us talk about the performance and the battery consumption. Well, since the device that I'm using is the Redmi Note 4, it didn't have any issues with the performance or the battery department at all. I tried to test it with my old phone, but unfortunately, this launcher didn't install in it. So, does it live up to the hype that they created? It does everything that they say it will do. Support for icon packs is there, the pixel top bar was a lifesaver in a lot of situations, and that tap home button to reveal app drawer and swipe down home screen for notification panel came really handy while using it with one hand. And yeah, how can we conclude if we didn't discuss about the cons? Okay, so let's start with the small ones. So first things first, you cannot change the grid size for the home screen. And when I tap the default clock widget, some app which I strongly believe is the clock opens and crashes almost at the same instant, which is weird. And whenever I change the icon scale, it didn't show up instantly. Plus, it's not supported in older versions of Android, as I mentioned above. Now, the next one is going to be my personal opinion. Maybe you'll find this as an added feature, but for me, it was not. I use two WhatsApp accounts using dual apps in my phone. But when I tap on the main WhatsApp, instead of launching the app directly, it shows another pop-up where you'll have to choose the account once again. So how do I rate this thing, and did it find a place in my phone as a daily? Well, since I'm working on another project for the channel and due to the existence of Nova Launcher, I dissed it. Honestly, if you spend some time tweaking the settings of the Nova Launcher, you can get the same look in your device. Plus, it's got a more promising performance and would guarantee a better battery life. So I can easily recommend Nova Launcher over this one, and I rate it 3 out of 5. Well, that wraps it up for this episode of App Detour, and in case you're wondering, I bought the Redmi Note 4 a few days back and I was facing a few issues with it in my real life usage. So if you're interested in the topic, stay tuned to the channel because the review will be coming soon. So with that said, I'm breaking it up for today, and I'll see you guys in the comment section below.